Hi everybody and welcome to another SciCraft episode. So in today's episode I want to build a fully automatic concrete farm that produces 108,000 concrete blocks per hour. So the entities that are duped in the overworld at the concrete powder duper would arrive here in the end dimension on top of the 5x5 obsidian platform. And since we want to completely redo our end dimension island, we need to remove it. So the plan is to remove everything here, all the obsidian pillars, the old buildings, the old farms, and then build the concrete farm. The only thing that would stay is our Enderman mob switch and the chunk loading grid here at the bottom. Everything else will be removed now. So I'll start by digging the obsidian pillars. Enemy is already busy, removed the first one, and then we try to salvage whatever is left from the farms. Okay, here's how I'm mining all those obsidian blocks. I just hold down left mouse button, then I use the F11 trick to log out. Then I set a timer on my mobile phone for 2 minutes, and then I just watch a video on the side or do something else, and this way it's actually bearable to mine all of those obsidian blocks. So we're almost done. On the right side we made a little counter, so over 25,000 obsidian blocks mined already between all of us. Alright, so enemy, the absolute madman, won this race. He mined 18,500 obsidian. All the pillars are gone. Let's take a little flyover. As you can see, completely removed all the pillars. Of course, those single bedrock blocks also have to be removed. Get some dragon eggs, and then we can continue salvaging what's left of the tree farms. It's probably also worth it to get the quartz here in the basement of the old trading hall and also save those clerics. They are really good clerics, they have the best trade for redstone dust, lapis, and I think also bottle of enchanting. So this was important, we traded a lot of redstone dust here, and to reset we also traded lapis, and the next one was always the bottle of enchanting. That's why we have 10 double chests of the other XP bottles. So the old trading room has been stripped of everything that is somehow useful, and I'll continue with the rest. I'll make a time lapse here. Unfortunately, the replay mod file got corrupted. I couldn't make a proper time lapse, just those few seconds there. So what we did here was removing all of the obsidian, also ender chests and water sources, in all of the old tree farms and also in the old wine farm. So as you can see here, we left over pretty much all the rest. There's really no point in getting repeaters and hoppers back and pistons. I mean, the resources you need for those are renewable items, and we can farm more of those. Okay. So, quite a chaos now. I already built up the TNT quarry, so it's the three-directional quarry with two duping modules. I also showed a tutorial a while ago, you can find a link in the video description, so this will take care of the whole end island. Not sure yet how far it will reach down, hopefully about layer Y30 or 40. So we definitely need to build up a second quarry at some point. And I definitely plan to do another time-lapse. I uploaded the latest replay mod version, hope it's a little bit more stable, but still a better version for 1.12. So I really hope it survives, because it's gonna be about 9-hour time-lapse to cover the whole end island. Okay, ready?
Yeah, should we start it?
Go. Okay. Bye. Alright, I think you can say this was quite a success. Of course, the flying machine didn't reach down completely because the endstone really has a high blast resistance, and also I have to build the machine above those end gateways, because otherwise TNT that lands on it would explode the flying machine, so I have to build it 15 blocks higher. But yeah, the first machine is still busy removing the old wine farm here in the back. Meanwhile, I built up the second machine, which I will send over now. Maybe we'll need a third machine, but this one should reach down to about 15, so there should be much left after this run. Okay, let's start it up. By now I also know by heart how to build it. Okay, I wish I could land here. Awesome. Okay. And it's running again. So now I also take out this part of the island. The first machine I was a bit careful so we don't blow up part of the old piston bolt towards the old trading hall. Alright, so this will run for another 11 hours approximately, and then we'll take another look at it. Alright, it's looking great. The TNT quarry removed pretty much everything except this tiny slice here at the bottom, and yeah, this little island here and there. It wasn't in the path to TNT quarry. Probably gonna remove it by hand. So there's some work left to do here for the quarry, like 2 to 3 hours. I think meanwhile I'm gonna remove this by hand. Also what's nice is that the piston bolt here at the bottom also got preserved. So the explosions happen at Y18 and yeah, this is out of the reach of the TNT. Alright, the complete end island has been removed. Also the wine farm is gone. The only thing we left was the chunk loading indicator grid out of glass blocks, but at some point it will also be removed. At the moment it's not hindering us. We're not sure yet what we do about those piston bolts, if we want to remove them, because they're also pretty pointless. We could just fly to the destinations now. Definitely we also want to remove the old sheep farm. At some point also build a new one, and our very first enderman farm, which is a eyesore at this point. Okay, now let's head over to the overworld to check out the concrete duper. I made my way over to the sand and concrete duper, brought over 12 concrete powder, and let's just remove the sand here, place it. Probably should have built up a beacon by now so we have jump boost, so I guess I need to use some ender pearls. Okay, so this duper can dupe 12 sand entities or concrete entities at a time, so that we get 108,000 powder per hour, which is all sent to the end dimension. Okay, it's been restocked. At some point I actually want to make an automatic system so it could switch the colors. Not sure if it's possible to switch between sand and concrete even, but it's definitely possible to make a system where I can switch between concrete colors. Okay, so we can turn this on at the bottom. What I also did was redoing the whole chunk loading array, so it's now permaloader compatible. Okay, this should work. Let's check it out. It's always a little bit laggy. I think the entities going through the portal to the other dimension creates some lag, but it has to be tested, I guess. Okay, the entities are duped now on the other side, and I also want to quickly talk about the chunk loading grid I did here. So it's been made compatible to work with permaloaders. Actually, that's not necessary. I have to hook it up again. Ah, good that I have some rats and dust. Okay. Life fixing. Okay. So this goes basically to the spawn chunks. What I did here was replace the old repeater line, something like this. The instant repeater line, so it goes to spawn immediately. And let's also check out spawn, because I made a little control room now. So this is the control room at the spawn chunks, so it tells us that the sand duper is running, and automatically turn on the permaloader and portal clock. So here you can see the instant repeater line incoming from the sand duper. It's all turned off. And that's the main storage line. Basically here it comes all in, goes to the displays with the torch tower, and here the signals would merge, turning on the permaloader information, redstone lamp, and yeah, turning on the permaloader. So this line goes towards the permaloader that I showed you, I think, last two episodes ago, which is about 4,000 blocks away from here. And basically, make sure that the sand duper is always loaded 100% of the time and not just 99.7% where it could break. Okay, now we actually need to hurry up to get back to the end dimension, because there's no active chunk loading grid at the moment and the entities would keep piling up. So if I would wait for 1 hour, then it would definitely crash. So let's head back over there. So as you can see, this is still running despite me leaving the area. This would also work while nobody's on the server now. Okay, let's go back to the end dimension for the server crashes. Definitely lag spike incoming. A few thousand entities, they have to be turned into items now. I hope it's fine. Maybe have three. Ah, doesn't say it yet. Alright, yeah, 1500 entities. 7000, oh my god. Hope this wasn't too much. This could go wrong. But he made it, okay. Yeah, all the entities were converted into items. That took a while. Of course, once we have to get jump loading grid re-enabled now, I think just some hoppers exploded here at the bottom, then the area will be loaded and yeah, nothing would crash. We also need to hook up the permaloader system here, which we need for the concrete farm, to the permaloader in the end dimension. So this would also run while nobody's on the server. Right, so I gathered all the materials, now it's time to build it up. By the way, it's the concrete generator I showed a few months ago during the snapshots, and I'm very glad that it still works. Alright, the farm has been completely built up and it's already kind of running. I already adjusted it. Let's head over to the clock if I can land there. So you also have to adjust this clock to get the right timings, otherwise the entities wouldn't land where they should. but I already got the timing right and just disabled here. The basically the clock saved the right timings and I can easily turn it back on. You can see the entities are split up in two halves and then further split up into eight streams in total. And yeah, what you can see here, that's always a packet of six entities. And this pack of six entities is shut up the slime block elevator here into this water stream, where they all convert into concrete blocks, so you can see it here. Then it just pushed further over and a little bit pushed around, so they could easily be broken by the TNT blast chamber. So the TNT blast chamber is also like 100% efficient, because TNT explodes in the moment when the entities are getting pushed, not the entities, the blocks are getting pushed. Okay, so the items land here at the bottom, where we can pick them up. Maybe I'll show you the speed of this farm. Let's empty a few slots, so you can see how fast this farm actually is. So we already got 1.5 stacks, 2 stacks, 3 stacks. Yeah, very fast, 108,000 items per hour. Okay, yeah, if you want to know in a little bit more detail how this farm works, as I said, there's a link in the description. So like a 10-minute video for a bit more detailed explanation. Alright, so methods is already busy, removing the old junk loading grid. And yeah, of course you can do black concrete. Just have to switch the colors, and we also have to turn the farm back off again. If we switch colors, go just back to the overworld. But as I said, I want to make an automatic system for this at some point. What we also want is of course a storage system. At the moment the items just despawn here. We need a shulker box filler and the chunk loading grid, so this farm also could be running while nobody's on the server. We still have to figure this out, hook it up to the permaloader in the end, and so on. Alright, so this was a lot of effort this episode. Removed the complete end island, dug the obsidian pillars, dug the old tree farm out of obsidian, and built this concrete generator. Hope you liked it. Have a nice day. Bye bye.